Hello, NCC Church family. This is our fourth week of Advent, and our theme this week is peace. Christmas is right around the corner, so just want to say Merry Christmas to everyone. I am in Colossians 1 in verses 19 and 20, and it reads, "For God was pleased to have all his fullness dwell in him," talking about Jesus here, "and through him," through Jesus, "to reconcile to himself all things, whether things on earth or things in heaven, by making peace through his blood shed on the cross." So God gives us a really strong definition of peace here in Colossians 1. But in contrast to that, when I think of peace, the first thing that comes to mind are one of those bumper stickers that you might see on the back of the car. It may say peace, or it might say coexist, and it will have different religious symbols that will be kind of mixed in with the letters of the word. It might have a Christian symbol, maybe a Jewish symbol, maybe some other religious symbols that you might not recognize as much. But the idea, I think, of the message with the bumper sticker is that even though we have different faiths, even though we have different practices religiously, we can still live peacefully with one another in the same culture, in the same society. And that's, I think that's a great idea. And that's totally fine. But when we're talking about peace biblically, we're talking about what Colossians 1 explained. First and foremost, this is the powerful peace that's in our lives, is that because of what Jesus has done for us, because Jesus came, was born as a baby, lived as a man, lived a perfect life, and then gave his life as a sacrifice for us, we are no longer enemies with God. We're not enemies with the Almighty God, the creator of the universe, a holy God. And that is the amazing peace that we have. So I have a two-step peace plan for us this week. And the first step is just to recognize that. Recognize that the amazing, powerful peace that we have is because of what Jesus has done for us. And secondly, because God has handled the big peace, both with the I and the E, now then we have an opportunity to share peace with others. So I would encourage us to think about just one relationship where there may be some tension, maybe there's some disconnect, maybe there's just some forgiveness that needs to be said or accepted, and think about how Jesus would want us to bring peace into that relationship. How could we put ourselves, just like he did for us, how could we put ourselves in a posture of service to bring more peace into that relationship? So let's pray together about those things. God, we thank you so much. God, thank you for the peace that you've brought us through Jesus. It's just totally uncomprehendable, your love for us. We thank you for the peace that we have with you through Jesus Christ. God, thank you for the opportunities we have to bring peace into our relationships. God, we know it can be hard to step into those sometimes, but God, give us the courage to do it. And God, we know that you are always with us. God, thank you so much for Jesus. And God, thank you for the opportunity for us to celebrate him in this season of the year. God, we give you thanks and praise in his name. Amen.